Just a fundamental, very fundamental thing about list. Okay, so let us go to the Python console once. Okay, and then we will see first these things, then we will go with the traversing a list. All right, so the thing is that when Python console will be opened, okay, how this particular thing will work, that we will see. Okay, so first of all, this anything that if we run, then it will the particular file will be appearing, the output will be appearing, then you can see out here, then we will come here, actually this one, this program we will come later on, but first of all we will see one very important thing about the list, that is, suppose you have declared a list out like this, list list 2, okay, suppose, and you have given like this list equals to you have given list equals to say Python, okay, p y, sorry, PYTHON. This list has been taken by us. Okay. And then what is happening? This list now I am trying to print. Suppose you see the list index starts from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in that way. Okay. Starts from 0. Now suppose here the maximum this thing is p 0 1 2 3 4 and 5, all right, so now I'm trying to print a list and I'm giving a 9. Okay, suppose, then see what is the error comes. This is the normal error comes normally whenever you are giving the index that is out of range. So here the common error, index error, has appeared, list index out of range, and this particular error has been shown. So the thing is that never give a range, never give an index which is beyond the range of the given list. All right. So this is a common error come. So this is a traceback error. Okay, in line 1, module list 9. Then this one, this is interactive mode actually. That's why it is not in program. In the program also, if it is been given in this way, the same error to come. Okay, that is the things. Now we are coming slowly to traversing a list. All right. So how the traversing to be done. All right, previously I had shown you accessing the list elements and all that I had shown you. Now basically the traversing a list means accessing each element of a list. This can be done using either for while or for loop or by using the while loop statement. All right, traversing can be done in the following two ways also. One I have shown out here, that is in, by using in. All right, so what is happening, the elements of a list can be accessed individually using for loop as follows. In this way, where they are in the list 2, they are stored in list 2, and when we will execute this program, then it will give us the output in the same fashion. Python program has been appeared in this way, all the characters has come horizontally. Okay, so if you don't give comma, it will give you the vertical output. All right, that is the thing. So list 2, so using in operator, this is clearly being written. So this is evident from the output that each letter is accessed and displayed on the Python shell upon execution. This is the Python shell, all right, execution. Each element is displayed, okay, displayed vertically, horizontally, as you have seen out here, and it will be traversed and displayed until and unless the list 2 has been exhausted. The element of list 2 has been exhausted. So the both the things to be that will be displayed, all right, that is the thing. So what is happening, in fact, this is using in operator for I in, this is the keyword in, that is the list 2, where it is appearing in list 2. Okay, so now the thing is that this Python program which you have received as output, this Python program is actually that this list has been accessed by using in operator, and every time it has been taken in this way, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. All right, so what is happening? So when 0 is in list 2, yes, then it is printing the directly I means that is the first index we are talking about, and where the value has been stored as PYTHONPROGRAM, total thing has been printed. This is one way. Another way is that you can see out here, okay, we can go for another program for traversing, that is in the range function. I have given you the already the YouTube link, okay, in order to see the range function once again. Maybe you know it, but still a reference has been given how to work with the range function and what is its functioning, students. All right, so that is the thing. Okay, Now you see this thing, this one we have used by using the range function out here. Range n means whatever be the length of the list, len command is used in order to measuring the length of the string. Okay, measuring length of the list. Okay, list elements. Okay, how many elements are there? That has been also been printed in this particular program. Now you see students, run. I'm doing then run execution of this is happening out here. Now see, it is going on. Okay, now see, it is showing you the same string that I have taken in list Python program. Total number of characters are 13. My count, which is giving you the total number of characters, the same traversing has taken place. Okay, so now the thing is that suppose if I would have been given the range function in this way, it is working. Suppose 0,5 I have given out here. Okay, so now the range I'm giving. Range run module and then see what is happening. You see 0 to 5, that means 0 to 4 it will take. That's why 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so but it is showing you total number of characters since lens is measuring that, but I am accessing only 5 characters. All right, that is the thing. So in this way, so the traversing takes place, but when I am mentioning out here n only, so it is taking the entire list into the range and it is executing starting from 0 to 14 all the 0 to 13 all the 13 characters, right? So that is the thing. So this particular program is actually helping out very easy representation or easy demonstration in order to understand how a string can be reversed. All right, how a string can be reversed, that is the thing. So you must do the practical implementation of these two programs, and you can see by changing its value. I mean, so now I'm showing you one more particular thing, which is actually the alias in Python. Aliasing in Python, variables refer to the objects. You know, the lists we create in Python are also objects we are referring to. Since lists are mutable, they can be modified, and if we assign the elements of one list to another list, both shall refer to the same object. Now say I am taking a list out here, subjects. Okay, subjects, subjects, or how it is, you see out here, this particular thing is subjects. I am taking a list out here, subjects equals to, I am taking here say economics is economics, economics, and then say English, and say what else, history. Okay, this is my subjects that I have taken. Fine. All right, now the thing is that this particular subjects I am taking in another variable called temp. All right, temp equals to subjects. All right, this is subjects has been stored over there. All right, now the thing is that what is that, suppose I am giving out here temp. Okay, temp, here it is, I am giving 0, then what it will print, this is printing all signs. Quite rightly it has been done. Okay, now say if I'm doing subjects, then what will be printing, then it is printing the all 4 data. All right, that is the thing. Now say I have taken say temp 0, temp 1. Okay, temp 1 equals to say I have taken Sanskrit. What I have taken, I'm taking Sanskrit, Sanskrit, Sanskrit. So this is actually demonstrating you that the lists are mutable. The elements of subjects in list in memory are represented according to their index value. All right, that's the thing. I will prove it now. So what I have done, temp 0, and I have shown you the original placement of the list elements. Okay, now what I am doing, temp 0 is showing you call signs. Now I am changing this one, and temp 1 is showing economics. I am taking temp 1 is also storing a new value that is called Sanskrit. All right, what now I'll see, I will print temp now, temp. Temp, you see out here, instead of economics it is appearing Sanskrit out here. That means it shows that the data are data in the list are mutable, and it is not immutable. And I'm showing you the same thing as subjects. Okay, that is also the same change has been taken place. So it is clearly proved that when I have changed the index value 1, the value of index 1, then the old value does not remain over here. So in this way we can say that two lists having the same set of values, in other words, temporary temp 1 is having the Sanskrit out here, and the subject is also having the same thing out. It is not like that. Whenever you have made the changes, both places, because since the temp is storing the reference of subjects, and when you have made the change, whether it is temp, and if you would have been changed into subjects, the same changes would have been take place. Let's see, we will do one for subjects also. Subjects, say subjects 2, it is actually now English. We will make it, say German, okay? So German, we will make it German. All right, now you see, subjects 2 I have made, what is the present stand? Political science, Sanskrit, English, history. Now political science, Sanskrit, English, history is also there in the subject. Now we're changing a value into subject 2. First I had changed over there, that change has taken place in both the places. All right, now subjects 2 I'm making German. Okay, now it has been, now let us see what the subject says. Okay, subject says, let's see, subjects when pressing, it has changed from English to German, and I'm giving also the temp also. What is happening? Let's see. Yes, the same thing, same change has been taken place. So either of the things you do, this kind of aliasing, this is called aliasing actually. This shows the variable referred to the objects, as well as Python list objects are mutable. Both the things has been proved with the help of an example. So apart from this range function, this is not in the part of the traversing of a list, but it is showing that how the elements of the list can be aliasing. Okay, this is called alias. Okay, that is the thing. So the thing is that if you are modifying one list, the changes has been taken place over there also. Okay, when you have stored the reference of the subjects list into the temp list. All right, so temp is also storing the same set of values. When after storing, when they have given temp 0, that's why the pole sense has that been appeared. And in the subjects also you'll have the same thing. Temp 1 we have changed Sanskrit, then the change has been taken place in both the places. And when we have changed the elements, the list elements in the subjects, okay, then the change also has been taken place in both the places. Okay, subjects and temp, this proves that the aliasing is possible in case of a list data, and list data are of mutable types. All right, thank you. So please do its practical and see it yourself, that whether it is whether you can do it or not, and it is authentic or not. That's the thing. So you can check it out, okay, by using your Python console. Thank you.